Good morning. How are you doing? We survived the Mercury retrograde. Yay. Anyways, you know me. To feel better about yourself. While I still look halfway decent, because I'm about to go deep in the desert and I'll probably look like Moses before I get up. Not that I'm any kind of. Yeah, anyway. Hi. I was thinking about something important. When people have terror moments, when they have traumatic incidents, like when they experience post-traumatic stress disorder, which is pretty much what the whole world is experiencing right now. See, I've experienced that in the past. The reason why I'm bringing it up is because I noticed a lot of people in the aftermath of their post-traumatic stress disorder, they cling to normalcy. They cling to what they know, you know, dancing with the stars or voices or whatever the crap is. They want their fast food. They want their, you know, Hulu or Netflix. And they want normalcy. They don't want to feel weird. They don't want to be scared, unsure about what's going on. And it makes it harder for them to change inside, to grow. And the sleeper doesn't awaken. Great movie. The new one I haven't seen yet, but I have high hopes. Great actors in it. So, my point being, when I was in my early 20s, I was at a Grateful Dead concert. Didn't think anything would happen. You know, I'm leaving the concert, my friend, and he stops to talk to some guy who he knows, and there's some girls there, and we're all just hanging out. It's like the parking lot. And so I'm just sitting down waiting for him, you know, and he starts talking to this girl, and my buddy starts talking to this girl, and I'm thinking, okay, well, you know, I'll give him a chance to make his play before we get out. And I'm just sitting there, and I look around, and I look behind me, and I see these six guys walking, you know, just like the old Western. They're all walking along, and I thought that was kind of weird. Anyway, they ended up trying to rob the guy that was my buddy was talking to and pulled a knife on him. And I was sitting down when I heard him say knives aren't cool, and I'm just like, what the hell's going on? I see these guys around him, and I jumped up, and as soon as I jumped up, one of the guys automatically just punched me in the back of the head, and I went blind. I couldn't see. Yeah, so for about 3 seconds, I was surrounded by guys that were hostile, and I couldn't see. And luckily, my sight came back. I was just like looking in the darkness, and all of a sudden I could see. I was looking at the ground, and my first instinct was to go and hit the guy that punched me, which I did. And I punched him in the face, and the guy behind him had a full can of beer, and he hit me full on the head. He just threw it, and bam, it just smacked me on the forehead. So I was like covered in beer and got smacked with a full can of beer, and then the fight was on. And the fight was on. And next thing I know, the fight was over. I mean, I was backing away from him, and some big blonde guy, I think I mentioned this in the previous video, some big Viking dude with no shirt on comes running up just to see if it was a fair fight. And I told him what was going on. He was like, dude, it's me and him against all you motherfuckers. He was pissed. So he basically chased all these people away. He was just huge. I was like, I thought I was going to fight him. And I was like, son of a bitch. Because he was like a linebacker. But it was a Grateful Dead concert. So you had all kinds of weird people there. But he saved my ass. Thank God. I don't know what the guy was, but I appreciate it. So he chased him off. I was stabbed, laying there on the ground, bleeding out in my back. I thought I was gone because I was around the kidney. So I'm laying there saying my goodbyes in my head to people I love and cared about. And, you know, and it was tough. And I was trying to keep it together because, you know, I'm surrounded by people watching me and stuff. And as luck would have it, I survived. Major surgery. My lung was punctured. My spleen was punctured. The doctor told my parents, inch higher or lower, and I'd be dead. So I got lucky. Okay, you know. So yeah, I survived that. And it's funny because when I first got out of the hospital, I mean, I was laying in the hospital in tubes, 5 days, just, you know, morphine machine and living off of, you know, tubes. And when I finally got out, there's this euphoria of being alive. I was weird. It was just like, so, I was so happy just to be here. I was jazzed, right? I mean, it wore off once I realized I could barely walk around the block, and I had to rehabilitate my own muscles and everything. Anyway, but I grew from that experience. I've never been the same, and I've always, you know, it changes you. I mean, I still have the post-traumatic stress where I don't like being around people and I get comfortable in rooms. You know, I'm better with my back to people now. I've gained enough power with myself and control that I'm good. I can deal with it. But, you know, when it first happened, I was like back to the wall. I couldn't go to bars or any of that kind of clubs because I would just too many people and I couldn't keep an eye on everybody. It was a security hazard for me. So I learned to deal with it and grow. And the reason why I'm bringing all this up is because I know that there's a lot of people suffering from the post-traumatic stress disorder, and they're not going to heal if they just, it's kind of like trying to cover the wound with bullet wound with a band-aid. It's not going to heal. It's just going to get infected and get worse, and you're going to start doing alcohol, which is just terrible. I don't drink, and I'm not going to promote that crap either. And that destroys so many lives, and it makes you, so many bad decisions are made on alcohol, trust me. So people get, pop drugs. I don't know what this fentanyl shit is, but, you know, people are dying and just turning into zombies where their mind isn't right anymore because they take so much of this crap. So you got to be careful and you got to love yourself and you got to deal with the issues at hand. The world is a different place. They unplugged the world, man. Everybody got unplugged from the Matrix for a second and you got a taste of a scary reality of not knowing what's going to happen next, and the people in charge are just not trustworthy and competent, so you know, we got that to deal with. But yeah, I want you to know it's gonna be okay. I love you. I mean, I survived some crazy shit and I'm still kicking, and it, trust me, once you gotta just face it, you gotta face the problems. I'm not saying it's perfect and it never will be. You're always gonna be a student, you're always gonna be learning, there's always gonna be suffering, there's always gonna be an asshole or two in the way, but most people are decent and they're loving. Yeah, I want you to love yourself. You're worthy, always. And so, realize you have post-traumatic stress disorder, no matter how it's insignificant. It causes anxiety and, it's negative juju. So, work it out, babe. Find a way. Stay away from pills. I tell people, I use medical marijuana. I'm not going to lie about that. It's the truth. It's natural. I can walk away from it. I don't have to take it if I don't want to. It lasts up to 3 days, so you don't have to take a pill every freaking day. And it's not addictive like they say. It's ridiculous. And you can go to your own pace. There's different ways of doing. There's CBDs, oil, there's edibles. I don't know. I'm just telling you, I don't take pills anymore. I do ibuprofen when I have to, when it gets really bad. But I don't do pills because they're just not, that's chemicals. It's not a natural. If it grows out of the ground, good for you. I don't do mushrooms or any of that other crap either. Not that it's crap. Some people really believe in that. I just think it's, that's a little too mind-altering for me. Unless you're going on a vision quest for a weekend to find yourself in center, that's fine. You got to get in touch with got to tap one foot into the etherical, the other world. Trust me, I know I've been tap dancing for years. I'm a bit off like that, but that's what makes people special, right? Anyway, I love you. God loves you and the universe loves you. I want you to have a wonderful day and love yourself, most importantly. Okay, I'm gonna let you go.